everyone, it's Penny Black and Jill Foster here for a new PB&J card class. And today I'm going to be sharing with you a set of cards. So I'll be creating 6 cards in total, showing lots and lots of different ways to use our creative die called Flowing Butterflies. So here is a look at this die. I just love using butterflies on my projects. And this die really offers lots and lots of different design variations that you can create with it. So real quick here, I am popping up a complete list or a list of the supplies used, and I will put this back up on screen at the very end of the video for each individual card. So if you want to look at it in more detail at that time, you can just hit pause and look at it on screen. Now throughout today's video, I'm going to be using some really great inks. These are Wendy, Vecchi Make Art Blendable Dye Inks by Ranger. And I've always loved Wendy's colors of archival inks, and I'm so excited she has now some blendable dye inks. So I'll be using those throughout the video and showing some techniques with those too. So the first technique I'm going to show is how to do a simple die cut shadow with that Flowing Butterflies die and a rainbow inked background. So here's a look at the first card that we will be creating. I am also throughout this video working on the Wendy Vecchi by Ranger, the perfect cardstock. And this is just a really nice, sturdy, but also very smooth cardstock that works really well with creating inked backgrounds. And I've die cut my die cuts from this and also my backgrounds. I am applying my inks to create this rainbow background using an ink blending tool and a foam pad. I'm starting off of the edge of my cardstock and working my way on in a circular motion. For this card, I wanted the heaviest concentration or the darkest color along the left-hand side of the card. So that's where I'm starting by applying the ink and then lifting up as I move towards that other side of the card. So I have it turned right now. It looks like I'm going bottom to top, but that was just the easiest way for me to apply those inks. Now, I will have all of the exact colors of inks, the stamps, everything used for each individual card at the very end of the video. But here I am using Red Geranium was the first color, Orange Blossom, and Sunflower. I am also adding some Fern Green right now. And then I will add the Garden Patina color. And I love how the colors of these inks, they're very vibrant and they're very rich, but they aren't neon. And for me, that is a quality I really look for in a color, that they can be bright and happy colors, but they aren't too bright, if that makes any sense. So I'm applying those, just continuing to do that, going back with multiple layers. I find it's easier to start light and build up the color by applying several layers. That's how I can get a nice smooth blend to those. They dry with a really soft, easy blended look. So they just work really well for creating this type of background. And rainbow colors are just so happy. So I thought that's kind of what I would use as a theme for all of these cards, just kind of a rainbow, bright, happy look to the cards. I added a little bit of orange blossom there along that right-hand side. And now I'm going in with the color of Acorn. And this is a really nice, neutral color. And it gives everything just sort of a distressed, sort of grungy feel, but isn't too dark or too over the top. So I'm just putting that mainly onto the corners of that inked background. So to add a little more interest to this background, I wanted to add a touch of stamping. And this is the Penny Black Transparent set called Life's Journals. And I love to add this for sort of a vintage look to the background. So I am stamping this in a stamp positioning tool so I can do multiple impressions and sort of build up the color and get it darker and darker. But you could do this on an acrylic block as well. I'm inking this with that Acorn color of the Wendy Vecchi Make Art Blendable Dye Ink. So you can also stamp with these inks. Now they are a dye ink, so they do react with water. So if you thought you were going to add splatters or anything to this background, then I would recommend using the archival inks, which also come in these same colors. So it's nice that you kind of mix and match and interchange those. I'm going to stamp this a couple of times, and you will notice I do not completely ink up the stamp. I'm just inking up the part that's going to be along that left-hand side and sort of letting it fade out as it moves into that background. So just partially inking it up and just partially applying the pressure with my hands along that left-hand side of the background. Now here is that beautiful Flowing Butterflies die, and I've just cut it from the perfect cardstock in the color of white. And now I'm taking the ink pads and just pressing the actual ink pad directly onto the die. And I'm using the red geranium, the orange blossom, and the fern green colors. And I'm applying this ink this way so it's really dark and saturated. I want this to have some contrast with the inked background that I already did. So by putting the ink directly onto the ink pad, it's just, or from the ink pad directly onto the die, it's just automatically darker than when I applied it with a sponge to the background. So this is how you can create an easy shadow for the die, and it makes such a difference when you put everything together. So I glued down the die that was inked, and now I'm just putting one that was cut from the white cardstock directly over top, but I'm going to slightly offset that, and that is going to create that shadow that also goes along with those background colors because I use the same inks to ink up that die cut piece. And here's a look at the finished card. I just added a die cut and stamp sentiment, and it was complete. So for our next card, I'm going to use that same butterfly die and do some layered butterflies. And with my inks, I'm going to do some detail inking right on those butterflies. So what's fun about this die is that you can just trim apart the butterflies from the die itself and use them individually. And like I'm going to do here is I'm going to layer them. So I've done that, and I've just put them onto a piece of masking tape that is not very sticky, so I can easily peel them up. And this just makes it easier to ink them. And I'm inking this first one with the red geranium color. And now I'm going to take a detail blending tool by Ranger, and this is just like a little tool with a foam pad at the end, and you can use it to just very carefully ink up just details on the die cut piece. And so actually the first color I used was the poppy color, and now I'm using that darker red geranium with the detail blending tool to add that towards the center of the butterfly and sort of work its way out to the edges. And you can see how these inks just really blend well together and how fun it is and how different the butterfly can look when you just trim it apart. So this is one of the smaller butterflies trimmed apart from that flowing butterfly's die. And for this one, I'm just inking it with the sunflower color. And in keeping with that rainbow theme, I'm going to move on and add some more colors to these butterflies. I'm starting here with the prickly pear. So this is a nice, bright, happy green. And on top of that, with the detail blending tool, I will add the fern green color. And these two colors really look nice together. I can definitely see using these for like greenery and leaves, die cut pieces in the future. So here I'm coming in now with that fern green right on top. And you can see how easily and nicely those two blend together. And then I'll use the garden patina color on this butterfly. So for the smaller butterflies, I could have done some more detail blending with those, but I just felt like there was enough color here to continue that out. So now this next color that I'm using is bluebird. I'm just putting that on with the ink blending tool and the foam pad. And then using the detail blending tool, I'll use the cornflower blue. And that just is a darker, richer blue right on top. And you can see how nicely those work well. And I'll be doing a sky later on another card. And you can see how those are great colors to use together. And then this is the violet color, which I'm using here onto this little butterfly. So I'll set those aside and work on my background. Now my background I used are Wavy Stitch Edges by Penny Black. This is a wonderful creative die. And I've just used this to add some interest to my background. So I took a 4.25 by 5.5 piece of cardstock and I cut that wavy stitch die sort of off to the left hand side. And I am now inking that very lightly with the acorn ink around the outer edges and along that die cut portion. And then I saved the other piece, and I'm going to ink that in the same way. And then I'll put these together on the front of my card panel. And this is just a fun way to add some interest to that background, but still let the butterflies sort of be the star of the show. And again, this is just being applied with an ink blending tool and a foam pad. and there's how those position together. For my sentiment, I'm using Penny Black's Creative Die Believe in Your Dreams and the In Yourself portion from our Transparent set there. And I wanted this to match that background inking, so I'm just pressing that acorn ink pad directly onto the white cardstock sentiment. And I will glue several of those together. So I die cut that Believe word several times, and I'll stack them and glue them right together so that there's a little extra dimension to that sentiment. Now, before I put my butterflies on, I wanted to add a few splatters. So I pressed that acorn ink pad onto an ink palette, picked it up with a brush and a little bit of water, and splattered that onto the background. I did cover up the area where I wanted to put the sentiment just so it wouldn't have too many splatters right there. And you can see how I assembled this card. I added my layered butterflies, kind of going up that stitched area of the die cut, and added my sentiments. So next I'm going to use the little smaller butterfly in the flourish to create a cheerful die cut embellishment and sort of create a very basic background inked scene. So here I'm adding my die cut sentiment and the butterfly to this scene, but you could easily add anything that you'd want. Green grass and a blue sky you could add to this card. So these colors work really well for creating that scene. I'm starting with the prickly pear ink and applying that going up the background of the card. And next I'm going to add the garden patina. So this is sort of up in the sky, starting off of the edge and working my way down. And again, this is that perfect cardstock by Wendy Vecchi for Ranger that has that really nice smooth surface. So it's really easy to blend these inks on there. It's also great for stamping too, which I'll show you in a little bit further along in the video. Now this is that bluebird color, and you can see how beautifully that goes with the garden patina. I'm adding it over the top, but not extending quite as far as I did with the garden patina. And I'm going to go back now with that garden patina and sort of blend over the top of that, just to unify all of that blue color together. Next, to darken up the bottom here, I'm going to grab the fern green and apply that, working my way up, but not extending quite as far as I did with the brighter green with the prickly pear. And you can see how easy it is to create this really bright, happy background scene that you could add so many different things to. Now, these inks do react with water, so I'm just going to splatter some water here onto this background, and you'll start to see the little droplets forming, and it just adds some extra visual interest, and I love the way that looks. I also think I can see doing some blue skies with this effect for some winter cards and kind of giving it a snowy effect by splattering it in the future. Now for my sentiment, I'm using Penny Black's Love and Roses, the big word love from that, and then the word you from our Perspective Transparent stamp set. And I've just die cut these letters and put them onto a piece of masking tape that is not very sticky, so they'll peel up really easily. And here I'm putting that fern green color towards the base of those, and then I will add the bluebird color up at the top. So I wanted them to be darker than my background, but still in those same colors. So putting several layers here just to make sure it is darker. And I did die cut this four times from the white cardstock. I'm only going to ink the top layer, but I'll glue all of those directly on top of each other, and it gives it a really great dimension when it goes onto the card. And that extra dimension just helps it make it more visible, since it is similar colors that it is sitting on top of. So I'm just checking there my inking. I decided to add a touch of that acorn color just right over the top of all of it. I'm using a very light pressure to do that, and that just, again, gives it sort of a vintage feeling. Now for my butterfly, I just trimmed away from that same Flowing Butterflies Creative Die by Penny Black. I trimmed away this little butterfly. I think it is so cute, and I love the little flourish that is a part of it. And I'm going to ink it using those same inks, the Wendy Vecchi Make Art Blendable Dye Ink, but using the detail blending tool. And I'm using that acorn color on the flourish and the sunflower over the entire butterfly. And this is a really small butterfly, and it's just so fun to be able to do multiple ink colors on it, including a different color for the flourish. Now, I forgot to get the body there, so I'm just going back in with that acorn color to apply that color to the body of the butterfly. And now I will use the red geranium with the detail blending tool to apply that towards the center of the butterfly and slightly extending out onto the wings. And to finish up this card, I just stamped the word you and adhered all of my die cut elements. And you can see how fun it is with that flourish that you can just pop that little butterfly and embellish lots of different scenes and sentiments and die cuts on your cards. Now for our next technique, I'm going to use, again, just only one butterfly. So with this die cut set, it's fun to really just cut it apart and use it in different ways. And I'm going to do some ink smooshing with the inks. So I'm using a really old acrylic block here, and it does have some grid lines that are slightly raised in it. And you will see that show up a little bit when I press it down onto my cardstock. And I'm going to just press the ink pads directly onto this acrylic block. And let's see here, I use the sunflower color, orange blossom, and red geranium. And then I'm going to just mist this, lightly mist it with water from a mini mister. And then I'm just going to press this directly onto my cardstock. Now, my work surface isn't perfectly flat here. So you'll see there's sort of the left-hand portion of that. You get lots of different texture where it didn't completely sort of smoosh on there. Now, I could use more water and keep going back at it to do that. But I really like when you get some texture with that, because I'm going to apply inks right over the top of this, and that texture is going to continue to show through. And I think that's what gives us a really fun, artsy look. So once that was dry, and I just sped up the process using my heat gun, now I'm taking those same three colors of ink, and I'm applying ink directly on top of that area where I smooshed the ink. So I'm just going to sort of intensify those colors, but because this is a transparent ink, you still get to see all that wonderful texture and sort of watercolory look beneath. And then I just simply trimmed down this piece and matted it and layered it onto my card with just one of the butterflies from the flowing butterfly die. Now to give this a finished look, because it is a very simple card, I did die cut from white our Stitch Stackers creative die set and stamped my sentiment from the Just Believe transparent stamp set. And it just gives it a really nice finished look, even though there is a lot of white to the card. Now, I think these flowing butterflies look beautiful with all of the penny black floral stamps. So the next card, I'm going to do some ink lifting and also feature our Summer Glow Cling Stamp. So to begin, I am stamping this onto the white Perfect Cardstock by Wendy Vecchi using Versamark ink. And then I'm going to sprinkle it with white embossing powder and then heat that to set it. And you'll see here when I start applying my inks that you can do the emboss resist technique with these inks. So you can apply that color directly over the top, and the areas that are embossed are going to resist that ink. I'm going to do that for my first step, but then go in and do some color lifting with these as well, which you'll see in just a minute here. Now for this card, I wanted to have sort of a greens and blues and even a little touch of that violet. And so I started light, and then I'll go in and sort of darken up the colors. So I kind of did a light version of the background and then went in and intensified that in different areas. And I think that just gives more depth of color to that background. So I did the fern green and then garden patina. Here I'm going in with that bluebird ink. and some of that violet. And for the color lifting technique, I find I really like to have a pretty rich saturated background so that when we sort of lift the color up from the stamped image, there's enough contrast there to be able to see what you've done. And I think that will make more sense as we get a little bit further on here. And then here's that cornflower blue color on top of that violet, and you can see that is such a beautiful combination, those two colors together. And then I'm just going back with these same colors and just applying more and more layers of ink. I think backgrounds like this are so fun to do and just kind of keep building them up until I'm totally happy with the result. And then I will also add just a little bit of that acorn color to give this that sort of vintage feel like I've done on the other cards, but concentrating it mostly on the corners and near the base of the card. Now we'll begin with the color lifting portion. Using just plain water and a paintbrush, I'm going to paint the image in. And I'm just going to apply that water, and then on the leaves portion, just sort of pat that with a paper towel as I go so that I'm lifting up the areas that are wet. Now, because these inks are reactive with water, then you're able to sort of move them and get almost like a ghost effect here when you are painting that in and lifting up the color. By patting it with the paper towel, that makes sure that I remove that color and it doesn't sort of settle near those embossed lines on the outside. And that's the look I wanted for the stems. Now for the flowers themselves, I sort of liked having a little bit darker edge right around the petal. So I'm putting my ink into the petals, but I'm not patting this with a paper towel, and I'm sort of just pushing that color towards the outer edge of the petals. And you'll see it's just a little bit darker portion of the petal near that line. And I like that look on the petals, just a little bit more variation. It's a subtle look, but it's just kind of fun. But this is such a great technique to use with your floral stamps, these line art images. When you're finished, it just kind of looks magical and soft, and it's just really fun to do, and it's really easy to do as well. And I find, though, I just want one more thing when I do this with the floral stamps, and these butterfly from the Flowing Butterflies die, where it's sort of turned and you're getting like a profile view of the butterfly, is really nice paired with our floral stamp. So I am just inking this up in the same dark blue colors of that background so that it's there, but it's not distracting from the floral technique. So it finishes off the card, but it isn't an accent really, it's just more of a finishing touch. Now I did stack several of these together and put the one that I colored right on top so that it had a little extra dimension since it is similar colors as the background. So here's a look at that butterfly and another look at the finished card. I just stamped a sentiment near the bottom and added a few sequins. So the final technique I'm going to show is how to back this butterfly creative die, and also you can use these inks to do some painting. So I'm going to stamp my background with Penny Black's Appreciation Set. This is a 3x4 inch transparent set, and I'm actually going to stamp this with Acorn Archival ink. So it's the same color as the Blendable die ink, but this is archival, so it can get wet and it's not going to react with water. So it's a wonderful ink for doing watercoloring. So I'm going to stamp this on an angle and fill in the entire background with that stamp. So it's just another way to sort of position that image onto your card. I'm pressing my Wendy Vecchi Make Art Blendable Dye Inks directly onto an ink palette and then just mixing in some water and using them to paint in my flowers. And I just did really simple basic painting. Where I wanted the color to be lighter, I mixed in more water, and where I wanted it to be darker, I used less water. And all of the colors, as with all of these cards, will be listed at the very end of the video in the supply list. So if you want to know exactly what colors I used here to paint this background, those will be listed. Now, I did do this on the Perfect cardstock from Ranger, and I found that it really held up pretty well to the water. I didn't use a ton of water, but I did not have to do this on watercolor paper, which is really nice since that is pretty detailed stamping, and I stamped it multiple times onto that background. It just saves some time being able to stamp it so easily onto a smooth cardstock, and it also helped it to be real easy to blend those colors. So once I was finished painting all of that in, I wanted to give this just a little more vintage look. So I'm using the Penny Black stamp called Footnotes and just stamping this with Bluebird Archival ink onto that background. I am not applying the ink all over the stamp, just here and there for sort of a random look. And then I'll just move that down and continue to stamp it in the same way across the entire background. And once that was done, I also added a touch of that acorn inking to the corners and then very lightly across the front of the card. And then to finish off this background, I'm going to do that backing technique with the flowing butterflies die. So if you want to have a solid butterfly with this die, you certainly can. It's pretty easy to do. I'm going to first just ink up the butterfly using the red geranium ink. And if my ink blending tool looks a little funny there, I've had this forever and the handle popped off years ago. And so it's just the same Ranger ink blending tool, just doesn't have the handle on there. Now with the sunflower color, I just pressed it directly onto the cardstock and then put a light layer of the acorn ink right over the top. I'm going to add a touch of liquid glue just in a few spots on the butterfly. And this is just to help it hold in place. I don't want to apply it all over the butterfly because I still want to sort of stick my scissors behind or between the two pieces of paper. So I want it to hold it enough so it doesn't wiggle when I cut, but not so much that I can't sort of slide my scissors underneath there. And all you do then is just cut around the background and then you can adhere it all together and back that die and get a solid look to the flowing butterflies. So here's another look at the collection of cards. I hope you've made it through this video. It was a pretty long one. If you enjoyed it, be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our YouTube channel. You can also connect with Penny Black on Facebook, Pinterest, Twitter, and Instagram on our website and blog. And I will link to all of those for you down in the YouTube description box below. And as you can see right up here on screen are all the supplies used in creating these cards. And if you see one you want to look at closer, you can just hit pause. Thanks for watching.